Getting your extruder to work perfect for the Sidewinder X1, X2 or Genius, all the artillery extruders. Here's what I discovered, and that's a difference like day and night here. The smoother and more continuously your extruder will push the filament through the nozzle, the better print surface quality you will get. Most probably your extruder looks exactly the same. Look at this shadow wobbling around here, coming from this unround running motor shaft plastic gear. I upgraded that one to this metal one here, which is running nice, smooth and evenly. Let's take a look how the extruder works inside. On my left hand you see the big heatsink. That's actually version 3. I will tell you later on in this video about version 1 and 2. If yours look a little bit different, that's okay. Here comes the filament. It pushes through the metal heat break with PTFE insert and then arrives at our nozzle. In between there is this aluminium heating block. Everything is bolted together and nicely aligned without any gap in between. And here's where the magic happens. The filament comes in and the molten filament comes out. In the next few minutes I'm going to show you at least 5 upgrades or little changes that you can do to your extruder to make him print better. A simple way for me to solve that problem is to put a little tiny spacer right between. You see? And that fills that gap so you can straight align the filament guidance with the heat break. This is how the original PTFE hose looks like. So that thing goes right in the heat break here. This is not an all metal heat break. That's why we have this PTFE part there within. So aligning all this together, I wanted to find out what is the right length of that PTFE hose there inside. Because if that has not the right length, it will move probably a little bit. And that will give us some air gaps. That's not good for, very good for the filament transport. What do we see here? Look at this. So the PTFE ends, even if I push this all together, this is the original PTFE, but you see the PTFE ends about 1.5 millimeter before the original heat break ends. So that's not good. That means I will need a new PTFE or make it a little bit longer with some spacer. Fortunately, before I already bought me some PTFE spare material. It's cheap to get everywhere. And I just lengthen a new piece, align everything together again. And just to check how to get it aligned and how to get the right length. So what you see here is that the PTFE, everything is aligned properly, and the PTFE stands around 0.5 millimeter over the heat break. And that's what I like, because so I have a little bit of pressure. But how did I do it? You see the trick here? I just took a second spacer. That's about 0.7 millimeters of thickness. And after that, I just cut that PTFE to the correct length using a cutter knife here. Okay. So that done, just remove this one spacer and it ends up with having this PTFE perfectly straight cut, and we have a little bit of pressure there so that the PTFE presses against the nozzle. As I found out, Artillery delivered three slightly different extruder versions. This one here uses a plain cylindrical heat break compared to that earlier one here. This one comes with a threaded heat break that you can just screw in or screw out, and it's just held by this thread we see here. To cool the whole thing, there is this cooling block just mounted here flat on the side. That's the same. It's the same cooling block for both versions. To me, the threaded heat break seems to be the earliest version that Artillery delivered. After that came that one here with this tiny two screws and that cylindrical heat break. It's manufactured quite nicely, you see. You can align this filament guide very straight. So that looks okay to me. Let's check how the parts fit together. Just want to know if there is any play, as we have seen it before where I used the spacer. It fits nicely together. Checking the bores here to align them. Okay. So there's not any play between that filament guidance plastic and the heat break. So there's no need at all to put any spacer between. It doesn't make any sense here. This is the original heat break which I was printing with over a year now. Taking this apart, I see that this was not good aligned at all. We see here my last filament. There's also this 1.5 millimeters of filament, molten filament, with the infilling and air gap between the nozzle and the PTFE. So I have never checked that before that deep, so it worked. I never had any issues with it, but it was in fact not correct. While retracting or whatsoever, this molten filament there creeping within the air gap, that can cause some jams or other issues that we don't want to have. Upgrading the original plastic idler arm with a cheap 10 euro metal one might be a good idea in this case. The new one comes in metal for about just 7 euros, quite cheap. In order to get this one mounted close enough to the motor, you have to remove the plastic housing there, and so you can reach this tiny little screw there. Let's check if this is better than before. And yes, it is. But I'm not totally satisfied so far. Now that this new metal idler has to go back in place, I found, well, this scraps a little bit because this bearing from this metal idler is so flush installed that it rubs against the new metal gear there. So easy to solve, I just took another spacer and pressed in the idler again. Oh, that looks good. That looks better. So the idler is not scratching on either of the gears. Checking the alignment for the filament path, and we see it's aligned perfectly. The filament will run here right in the center of the gearing. Loosening that little hidden screw here is important. So I can move around the plastic housing against to the aluminium body. And that way I can adjust a little bit, at least, the play between the little and the larger gear. Checking once again, everything rotates freely, easy and smooth. It still does. And I still have a little bit of play here. I want to have that play. That little play is the guarantee that everything goes smoothly. Since the gearing ratio is so high, that little play we just saw doesn't have any negative effect on the extruder accuracy at all. It's a good idea to tighten up one screw after another and in between, just checking if the big gear runs freely and soft. And I can feel here that there is a little bit of interruption. It doesn't feel that good anymore as just before, with no screws in there. So something went not good so far. Opening the whole thing again and looking how much play can I introduce here at all, just by moving this a little bit around, loosening therefore this little hidden screw again, and trying to max out the play. But it still didn't work. Checking here the holes for the screws, and the holes are 3 millimeters as the screws are. So I came up with that idea to widening those holes a little bit. And here I used a 3.5 millimeter drill so that the holes are 0.5 millimeter larger in diameter now as there are before, and that gives me a little bit something like 0.25 millimeters more of play in either direction. And I was hoping that this would be enough to get a free play introduced there. To mount everything back in place together, I just used the two screws on the left side just to place them in order to align that whole plastic body part, and maxed out the play I had now available, screwed, tightened the hidden screw again, and so I was sure that nothing is shifting more around while putting the whole thing together. Here is the next strange finding. By taking a close look to this large gear here and checking the bearings, I found that the bearings, at least what we see here, that the bearing is sitting quite comfortable here within the aluminium body, and it has on the back a little bit of free space so that the inner bearing ring is not scratching on the body itself. Okay, so putting the whole thing together here. The construction comes within M3 screw that goes right through the middle of this gear. And by tightening this screw, we will squeeze, we will push together against the two ball bearings, which is of course not good. The more you tighten the screw, the more pressure you will introduce to the ball bearings there. And this is not the way ball bearings should be mounted. So I decided that we have already 1, 2, 3 screws that build a triangle, and those three screws are enough to hold the whole body together. So actually, I don't need necessarily the fourth screw, which runs right through the middle of this big, of this large gear there. So I decided not to use the fourth screw. Now that we are almost done checking the extruder, before putting together the whole thing, just a last quick check. This filament guidance plastic thing here, just check that this one does not rub against the extruder gear there. Everything possible seemed to be done, but what's this? It still doesn't run smooth. There is one particular angle where the big gear here goes a little bit harder. Wow, that's not satisfying after so many details that had been solved already. So it must have to do with the big gear itself. So I left with no other option than to go in with a little cutter knife here, really within the teeth, after I marked the right position where it went a little bit harder. And after that, I scratched around here a little bit with my file, and just to get a little bit more of free play on that particular side of the gear here. And finally, the extruder gearing went as smooth as I had dreamed it to run. So I am happy. I have never had an extruder within my hands that runs as smooth as that one here.